From the record on disciplinary proceedings, it intimates that the petitioner has written an application dated 1 December 2001 to the inquiry officer requesting therein to supply the copies of the statement recorded, if any, during the course of inquiry. On this application, there is an order of the inquiry officer to the senior administrative officer to supply copies of the documents on deposit of requisite fee so that he may submit his written reply in time, but there is no document to show that the documents so demanded were actually supplied to him. On 3 December 2001, the petitioner again wrote an application to the inquiry officer demanding 13 documents, details of which is given in clear words in the said application. There is an application dated 15 January 2002 on the petitioner on record, in which petitioner has requested to keep the inquiry proceedings in abeyance as he has given a representation to the High Court for transfer of inquiry to some other district. There is no order on the said application. There is another application dated 22 January 2002 written by the petitioner to the inquiry officer demanding certain documents, apparently that too were not supplied to enable him to fit his version effectively. Moreover, the petitioner had indicated the relevancy of the documents so demanded by him. Similar request was made while application dated 2 December 2002 and 8 February 2002 and 28 February 2002. There is nothing on record to show that at any point of time the inquiry officer had observed that the documents demanded by the petitioner are not relevant, or the witnesses whom the petitioner wants to examine are not relevant. On the contrary, there is admission of the opposite parties that the petitioner had demanded the documents. Mere saying that the documents were supplied to the petitioner would not absolve the responsibility of the opposite parties. There is no documentary evidence later to prove that the documents so demanded by the petitioner were supplied through a letter. It may be added that the stand taken in paragraph 14 of the counter affidavit is contrary to the record produced by the respondents. It may be added that in the charge sheet, the primary charge against the petitioner is that during preliminary inquiry, it was found that a racket is operating for filing fake claim petition on fictitious names with fake documents, and petitioner is also involved in filing the fictitious claim petitions with the aid of certain clerks and advocates. A perusal of the inquiry report reveals that the inquiry officer did not examine any witness to prove the charges leveled against the petitioner, and only on the ground that there is no denial by the petitioner, it has been held that he was involved in the racket and recorded that both the charges proved. There must be clinching evidence to connect the delinquent employee with the charges labeled against him. It was the peon's duty of the inquiry officer to ascertain the truth, being the independent investigator, as to how and in what manner the petitioner is involved in racket. He should have also ascertained as to who are other employees, clerk involved along with the petitioner. On perusal of the inquiry report, it can easily be gathered that the inquiry officer has proceeded in haste with a predetermined mind and did not observe the settled procedure in the matter of departmental proceedings. The inquiry officer did not bother to examine the departmental witnesses to prove the documents relied upon the utilized against the petitioner. For the reasons aforesaid, we are of the definite view that the inquiry proceedings, besides being vitiated on account of non-supply of relevant documents and copy of the preliminary inquiry report before inflicting major punishment, but also cannot be sustained
sustained being in blatant disregard of the principle of natural justice. It is pertinent to add that the specific charge against the petitioner